Today's video will be co-hosted by my cat, Ketzel.
So, if I'm ever looking to answer a specific problem, whether I be stuck on a computer programming issue or how do I do something in Premiere, pretty much my go-to is always YouTube. Right now, I'm doing an art course on Udemy, and a Java course on Udemy is what finally got me to sit down and start programming in Java several years ago. While I didn't understand Masterclass at first, it's given me a lot of value. And LinkedIn Learning is probably the closest you'll get to a college-level curriculum. Hey Internet, my name's Mark, and if you're new here, I'm an NYU student, and this semester all of my classes are online. Fortunately for me, it's a medium that I'm used to working with, and today I wanted to make a video kind of ranking all of the online platforms that I have ever used to learn just about anything. Since we're all at home and our opportunities to go out into the real world are limited, we can go ahead and learn from so many different platforms online, and today I'm going to talk about 4. And which one might be best for you. So this video is yet another relaxed form of video because I've really enjoyed doing it for the last video that I made. But anyway, I'm doing these in the order of what I deem to be the most professional online platforms. YouTube to Udemy to Masterclass to LinkedIn Learning. Now, if you're looking for a specific platform, you can find the timestamps on the video bar down below and in the description. If you want to skip around to a specific platform, definitely do that. But I do bring up each platform in a scope of another platform as I go through. One last note before we jump in, some courses can be found on various different platforms. Someone could make a course that they publish to YouTube that then goes to Udemy that is also on LinkedIn Learning. That being said, I'm going to use my general experience because on each platform I have watched through at least a few, if not several, individual videos, and I'm averaging out the experience I've had over those courses and those videos. So we'll start off with YouTube, probably the most informal platform, and I don't really think it needs an introduction here since you are on the platform now, but what's relevant is that anyone can upload a video, and if they want to make it more than 15 minutes, they just need to confirm that they're human. My main incentive for using YouTube is just quick and easy solutions. If I'm looking up how to use a linked list in Java and I don't want to use an article online, then I can watch a small YouTube video that explains the concept. For my machine learning class, StatQuest videos were like my savior when explaining statistics in very visual and easy to understand ways. In other words, I used YouTube for very specific things. For something like Adobe Premiere Pro, there are videos of like a maximum of 3 to 4 minutes long that really quickly explain how to do something in Premiere. So I use YouTube to find these very individual concepts. But you can find people who make amazing courses on YouTube. One of the higher level type of courses I've seen is Blender Guru and Making the Donut in Blender. The organization there is fantastic. However, you really won't find much of that on YouTube. In general, I think the best part of YouTube is that it's free. There are unlimited videos, so you might find different perspectives. You're gonna get so many different perspectives here on YouTube by people who have just made videos talking about the subject. Also, YouTube will give you the best content. If I look up how to use Blender 2.8, Blender Guru's donut video is likely to come up because it's very well made, it's very popular. That is a representation of how useful people have found it. That being said, anyone can make content, so again, you can get multiple different perspectives, but that leads us right back into the cons of anyone can make content. If you're on a video, just make sure that the person sounds like they know what they're talking about and look in the comments because oftentimes I've gone to videos and the comments will be like, you didn't do this or, you know, this wasn't right. And that's a pretty good metric to go by. If a tutorial is large enough, you will not have much support from creators. I know a lot of creators have responded to comments. Game design tutorials I've looked at on YouTube, the author of the videos will often be in the comment section responding to comments. However, if someone's large on YouTube, they might not do this as much. They just can't. YouTube has no requirements for people to make a course very structured, and this will come up in later learning platforms. And lastly, tutorials are not maintained. YouTube doesn't say, hey, you need to update your Blender 2.7 tutorial to 2.8. It's just gonna leave it out on the internet. And if that video is really good, as in popularity and ratings are great, then if you're looking up a Blender 2.8 tutorial and you don't put in 2.8, you might get a 2.7 tutorial on accident and get a little lost with the outdated software. Blender's a pretty bad example, but hopefully you understand what I mean. So, all in all, if you're looking for quick one-off things to do, YouTube's your best bet. You don't need to pay for an entire course just to learn about what a sine function does, for example. You can find a YouTube video on that. If you need something to help with you, oh my God. If you need something to help with a class or something, check YouTube first for that specific topic. Stop! But otherwise, if you're looking for a more specific course or something like that, let's move on to Udemy. If you haven't heard a Udemy ad on YouTube, I'd be a little surprised, but then again, I use Udemy quite a bit, so I'm not surprised that their ads come to me. Overall, Udemy is a platform where anybody can create a course and upload their entire course onto the platform. You can learn pretty much anything on the platform. There's art videos, there's math videos, there's so much more. Now, the thing about Udemy is that most courses you'll find are by people who are professional teachers or at least put in a professional effort. If I wanted to make a tutorial on YouTube, I could make two or three videos and then give up and be like, eh. But Udemy requires you to write out a curriculum, to structure your videos. I haven't seen the behind the scenes process, but you're not gonna get someone who's releasing a video every 3.5 weeks. Udemy also has sales pretty much all the time, by the way. There's like 10% off sales, first time account sales, all that jazz. Now, with this professionalism of support and the platform, you know, not being hugely saturated, it is kind of saturated, but you get really good support from the creators of the curriculum. There's kind of two ways that I have seen great community. On the drawing course I'm taking now by Neil Fontaine, he responds to comments specifically on his page, and he'll sometimes post the videos that he makes on YouTube to the learners, and he'll respond one-on-one. Whereas the Blender course I'm taking by GameDev.tv, I'm also taking their Unreal Engine course, they have such a big community. There's a Discord server, there's a website, there's a forum page, that they kind of redirect you away from Udemy, which is not a bad thing. And they do it very well. The community can help you this way, and the instructors do offer live Q&As pretty often. On Udemy, it's a lot more interactive because of that lower level of professionalism. Now, on YouTube, where there's zero professionalism, and LinkedIn Learning, where there's pretty much utter professionalism, Udemy's kind of nice in the center, a little towards unprofessionalism, in the sense that there are no rules about how an instructor can interact with their community, and the fact that there's no one saying, hey, you need to make this course, it's entirely of their own volition. Anyone can upload content, again, so you might get a course that's 10 bucks, or even free, you might start committing to it, but it's just not a high tier quality. So definitely go by the ratings and see what everyone's saying. Udemy will promote its top sellers, and it does that for a reason. Courses are structured, but you need to pace yourself. With something like Coursera, which quite frankly should be in this video, but it's not, Udemy doesn't say, okay, section one is due in 3 weeks, section two is due in 4 weeks. You need to look at the curriculum and pace yourself. And I'd recommend setting a goal. I want to finish part one by the end of the month, and then break it down from there. Because when you see 64 hours of art lectures, it gets kind of overwhelming. Udemy can be really easy to just browse and browse and browse. Like, you might go to a bookstore or Amazon and buy a book and then never get to reading it. You might buy a course and then never get too far into it. So when you buy a course, don't forget to set the intention to take action, because Udemy will not push you to do so, which isn't really a bad thing. It's just something I found that I wish I had. So if you have some free time or have been looking into a new hobby and want to learn the basics, in other words, you don't just want to learn by application, like jumping into Blender and making something, you want to learn the specifics of the program, Udemy is fantastic. When I first took a Java course on there, probably 6 or 7 years ago at this point, it was by John Purcell, I believe, on Cave of Programming. There wasn't anything fantastic about the course, but the unprofessionalism was the best part. Now, this exists on other platforms, but I have noticed this consistently on Udemy courses. The best courses I have ever taken on Udemy offer challenges. GameDev.tv at the end of each lecture says, go mess around in Blender, do this, this, and this. In the art lecture, it's, okay, stop watching, do this, this, and this. If you don't apply what you learn, no matter the platform, you will not learn it. That is just a simple fact. Learning by osmosis is not a thing. GameDev.tv urges you to do the challenges each time. When you do the thing, and then you're like, crap, I don't know how to do this, you're pushing yourself to remember, and that's where learning takes place. Anyway, Udemy courses can also supplement your other courses very well. My first year of college, I was taking Calculus 2, having a rough time. Online Udemy Calculus 2 course by someone whose name I'm totally spacing on, but I'll put a thumbnail here. Super helpful. I got it for 10 bucks when it was on sale. There were workbooks and problems to do, and it taught me things outside of the course, and it was super helpful. Now, this is important, because if I'm taking Calc 2, whether in person or online, the benefit of these online courses is that they have been tailored to go at your own pace. So with the Calc 2 videos, the person has a script on the side likely and is doing problems, and that's why it's so cohesive, and that's why it's so helpful. So if you have a teacher or a professor who's not used to the online medium, then find someone who is, right? So, masterclass. I'm sure that a lot of people who clicked on this video are coming from the masterclass section. So, hello? Is masterclass worth it? Is it not worth it? What's going on? I feel like everybody has seen the masterclass ads. If you've been following the rest of this video, a lot of the platforms have creators that encourage you to take specific action. On my game dev course on Blender, they're gonna say, go ahead and make something out of primitive shapes. You're not gonna get that on Masterclass. However, you might get something more valuable. Masterclass's name is very pertinent. It's very relevant. You're not learning to become a master, you're learning from the masters. One of the best things we can learn from someone in any case is their own experiences, what they've been through and how they've gotten to where they are. And this is the core concept that Masterclass lies on. Will Wright's course is why I signed up for Masterclass. I had just finished my Game Design 101 class, and I absolutely loved his course. I took notes on it and everything. Every few videos or so as well, and this happens in every Masterclass, there are live demos of the concepts you've been discussing. In Chris Voss's Masterclass, and all the negotiation concepts he's discussing, every three or four, he has a mock negotiation with an actress, and they're really well done, and it's really cool to see these things in action. Anyway, I want to make the point of Masterclass very clear. I have taken 5 courses on Masterclass. As someone who has learned on Udemy, YouTube, LinkedIn Learning for so many years, I had a certain expectation for Masterclass. That expectation was not met. I was looking for methods to learn. I was looking for how I can most rapidly learn these topics. I was looking for something pretty specific, but the questions that came out of learning from Masterclass were ones I'd never even considered asking. And honestly, they were very valuable.
Valuable.
They're distilling their experiences into a very digestible format. Very digestible format. Joel, or Dead Mouse, I feel weird saying Dead Mouse amongst all these other names, and Christina Aguilera's course both discuss how they've just messed around with songs. And for Joel, this is messing around with different synths. For Aguilera, this is messing around with, well, not really messing around, but digging deep and finding different emotions and singing in different ways. They've experienced trying and failing and succeeding, and they relay these experiences onto you. So maybe you've understood what I'm trying to say, but I suck with words. Masterclass is unique in the fact that not only do they grab you with these famous people, but you get to see their workflow. Deadmau5 is probably the best example of this. You're not gonna sit down and you're not gonna have Deadmau5 saying, all right, this is Ableton Live, here's how you use a DAW. That's not how he learned. All of Wright's core lessons come from what he learned with Spore. From The Sims, he constantly mentions his bodies of work and what they can show about the theory he's explaining to you. When you look at Deadmau5 or Chris Voss or anyone who's a professional in their field, Masterclass gets you past, wow, this person's really smart, and into, wow, this person really worked hard. I have a video on why I think talent is arbitrary, which you can find here, but I want to say this again. Masterclass gets you past, this person is really smart, to, this person has worked really hard for really long and really knows what they're doing. When you're watching a course on Udemy or doing a course in college, it can be so easy to get to a homework assignment or challenge and think, oh my God, I'm stuck. I don't know how to do this. I'm never gonna. That's what Masterclass shows you. That's the beauty of it. You're supposed to feel like that. Deadmau5 talks about how he just kind of messed around with things and sometimes deleted entire portions of tracks that he didn't know what to do with because they just didn't sound good. Will Wright talks about these mistakes and small features that they made in their games in the past and how many times they prototype things. All in all, Masterclass's big takeaway is that no matter how you use something or how you do something, sit down and just apply it. Udemy challenges can help guide us on what we need to learn. A downfall is that they take us away from the project we might have our minds set on in the end. I might need to learn Blender and programming for a game I want to make, but at some point I have to sit down and make that game, not spending time on these challenges. Masterclass gives you a survey concept and the professionals tell you their experiences so that you can kick off your own. I could talk about this a lot more for a lot longer too, but I do have to end the Masterclass segment here. I honestly might make a video on this topic. I just screw it for pros and cons of Masterclasses because it just feels like such a different platform. It's not a curriculum. It is an insight into how someone has learned what they've learned, not just how you can learn it. And if people are curious, if you want to see more, I'd be happy to make a video entirely on Masterclass because I think it's really important. And hey, when you're done with Will Wright's game theory class, then go to Udemy or his LinkedIn Learning, which we'll get to in just a minute, to learn Blender and programming and all that stuff. But we're on the last one. So LinkedIn Learning used to be called lynda.com. Since then, the courses have evolved. They've become more up to date, more regularly maintained, but they are still very professional. Now, you could say Udemy is a paid program where anyone makes a course and there are a few gems, but LinkedIn Learning is a much more structured version where you can rely on a course that you're watching being made by a professional. One of the courses I've been doing recently on LinkedIn Learning is also available on Udemy. It's Using Flutter and Dart by App Brewery. And in this course, they utilize challenges. They have you make small app projects. One of the best things about LinkedIn Learning, and Udemy has this as well, they have course files. So a lecturer, if they're talking about code or an app, they have course files that you can follow along with. The courses on LinkedIn Learning are very structured. These people are not only professionals, but they are in a very structured manner. You are learning how to use software and different platforms and different coding languages. The courses meet a standard of what I think would be a college level lecture. Throughout the platform, courses are broken down into curated playlists, modules. If you're only looking for a specific thing, they pull videos from different courses into a certain playlist is what I mean. Now, some of the cons. So in its professionalism, you might get someone who is just very blatantly talking at you. And they're often following a script. In a lot of ways, this is not a bad thing. Right now, I watch the At Brewery videos on 2x speed, but the person who explains the videos is really engaging. She's got a lot of mood and she's following a script from what it sounds like, but she knows what she's doing. The course is very laid out. Every minute of the video, there is an agenda. You might not find this on Udemy. You definitely won't find it on YouTube. As a result, the videos may go slow. Put them on 2x speed, do the challenges, follow the course files, you're good to go. Skipping around can be good. For example, if you're doing a Flutter course and you're like, oh, I already know about polymorphism and encapsulation, you skip those. There could have been something that the teacher mentions in those videos that becomes relevant later on or for the project you're working on overall. That's happened a few times in a Premiere video series that I was watching. And lastly, LinkedIn Learning is largely software-based or very programming-based. There are some Blender courses, but you'll largely find like how to use Excel, Premiere Pro, app development. And with this caliber of course, this college-level online course, that's just the trade-off you have to go with. For these higher tier, more professional courses, you have less volume and thus less topic coverage. So who's this for? If you're a college student, first of all, check this platform because you might have access to it for free. I bought the At Brewery course on Udemy, realized I had it on LinkedIn Learning and refunded it from Udemy, and I got on Udemy for $15 during a sale. They have trial lectures, so definitely give it a shot. But I will tell you, it is because of LinkedIn Learning, I have learned some very niche tips and tricks in Premiere. When you're in Premiere, you quickly Google up how to cut video, how to use the slide tool, so on and so forth, and you get very specific answers. For platforms like Udemy and LinkedIn Learning, they teach you much more about the intricacies of things. Sure, you have to go through the nitty gritty and boring stuff, but I will tell you that some of the things I've learned from LinkedIn Learning courses on Premiere have saved me several minutes, which in the end saved me hours of workflow in Premiere. Simply hitting the tilde key while your mouse is in a certain window expands it to the full screen. Just very small things that are hugely helpful. And to sum that up, it's simply just presenting you with this tool in Premiere that you never would have thought to think about because you already have a way of doing it, but this way that you never thought about, infinitely better. And you'll really only find that in a structured course like Udemy or LinkedIn Learning. So I've been recording for 42 minutes. My throat is starting to hurt, but thank you so much for watching this probably 20-minute video. If you have any thoughts on these platforms or are curious into what my opinion is on a specific platform, maybe giving you more insight about why you should or why you should not go on a platform, I'd love to hear it in the comments down below. I feel like a whole video on the idea behind Masterclass and how to make the most of Udemy, those videos might be super helpful for people. And as always, it's always dependent on you and your situation. No platform is for no one, no platform is for everyone. But alas, thank you yet again for watching. Don't forget to keep learning. And as always, don't forget to stay awesome. Peace out.